My ship's being used to move your contraband, and now you want to sneak into one of our warehouses.
Kurt was given the order. If we want to help him, we don't have a choice.
I don't like this. But since I've been sacked, let's just say that this will be a little bit of revenge.
How are we to know in which warehouse we'll find this damn cargo?
I'm afraid we're going to have to take a look at all of them.
That won't be necessary. My entire cargo has been placed in the warehouse closest to my ship. And if you wouldn't mind wearing some Nort clothing, we'll be less suspicious. I would like to avoid fighting with my own. The Norts are my family.
Presses made to order! Best forge in Tir Fridhi! Blades, armor, locks, custom pieces made to order! Closer, good people. Liqueur and wine from the continent. Tir Fridhi alcohol.
Please express my most sincere admiration to your cousin. He's such a fascinating man.
I need a bit of practice.
Excellency, welcome back to my modest shop. It is an immense honor for me to be of service to such noble clientele. What might I do for you?
For your visit. See you soon.
Come closer, good people. Liqueur and wine from the continent. Tier for D alcohol. Closer, good people. The cure is going for...
Captain Reuben?
Aye, the man himself. To whom do I have the honor of speaking?
De Sade, legate of the merchant congregation. And I'm sure you know my companion.
Frasco? Oh, do not worry. The seahorse is in good hands.
I'm sure, Reuben.
What brings you here?
The Admiral told me that you were the new captain of the ship we arrived on.
The Seahorse? Yes. It's an excellent ship and a good crew. But you did the crossing. You know it as well as me. Did you want to know anything else?
That'll be all, Captain. Thank you.
No. These aren't the right crates. These aren't the right crates. Here are the crates we've been looking for. It appears that one of them has been broken. It's full of weapons.
That doesn't seem right. It is our clients that supply us weapons on Tirfredi.
You didn't know what was in the crates?
No. I don't concern myself with the commander's business. I should take a look into this. I have some friends here that must know what this is all about.
Let me know what you discover. Now, let's mark these crates and get going. No. These aren't the right crates.
bit of poison on my brain.
Welcome! It's such a pleasure. Have you seen any...
your visit. See you soon.
Hello, Your Excellency.
We have found a way into the storehouse and we have marked all of the crates.
Perfect. I shall ask my men to follow the same path.
One of the crates was damaged. I was quite surprised by what I found in it.
Really? To be honest with you, the commander never told me what was in them. I received the order to deliver them as soon as Kurt accomplished his mission without any further instructions. For what it's worth, I thank you for your help. And I hope you can accept this modest token for everything you've done.
If you have another moment, Your Excellency, I would like to ask you for your help. We have a serious problem that I did not hear of until recently. A problem that concerns you closely.
I'm listening.
I was told that some of our soldiers have been extorting large sums of money from the town merchants under the pretext of financing their protection.
Are you telling me that the guard is extorting merchants in our city?
Indeed. Some merchants have been assaulted, and one of them has even been found dead.
I hope you don't intend to conceal this information. If my cousin learns of this...
Oh no, certainly not, Your Excellency. We intend to punish the guilty party with the greatest severity. But the merchants refuse to give us the slightest testimony. The guard frightens them, and rightly so. We won't be able to put a stop to these crimes without outside help.
Count on me. I'll take care of it. No, thank you.
Oh, it's a great pleasure to see you again at the forge. What can I do for you?
I'm currently investigating an extortion case involving the guard. Are you one of the merchants who has been threatened?
No, not at all. I've never heard of this business. Someone must have lied to you.
Really? Come on. If you want these guards to be arrested, you need to talk to me.
I mean no offense, but you won't be able to do anything. And snitching don't end well. I want to hold on to my business and my life. How about some new armor, Your Excellency?
I was told that someone found a merchant's body. Did you know him?
Of course. The town isn't that big. We all know each other here. Poor Renault. We found his body on the street by the port. He was beaten to death. One of his associates half-heartedly took over the shop.
Have the culprits been found?
No. Listen. Nobody wants to talk about this. We don't want any trouble. It's been months since it happened. An investigation's not gonna bring him back.
You are obviously a victim of these bandits. One of your people is dead. Yet you refuse to help me. Why?
It's precisely because one of our people is dead. Now, you can either buy something or let me get back to work. Because I am not gonna say one more word about this case.
The law of silence is at work. Nobody saw anything, nobody knows anything.
Want armor that fits you like a glove? We'll make it for you.
Come closer, good people.
Sire, I am pleased to welcome you to the best wine and spirit shop in Tir Fridhi. If you're looking for something to accompany a fine meal, or for a gift for someone, you've come to the right place.
Thank you, but I'm not here for that. I was told a merchant had been found dead.
Really? Oh, I didn't know. No one told me about that. What was his name?
Come on, don't take me for a fool. You know very well who I'm talking about.
I don't, really? I don't. So, what sort of wine would you like to pair your food with? You need something strong when eating game.
I'm conducting an investigation. Some merchants are being extorted by members of the guard.
Are you sure? It's probably just a nasty rumor. Someone must have misinformed you.
Come now. I'm the legate of the congregation. If guards threaten you, I could arrange protection for you.
Threats? No. I assure you.
You're obviously terrified. Don't you think it's better to tell me everything?
Listen, I've no desire to get into trouble. Please leave me.
But if you don't help me, you will never be rid of these guards.
I told you, I don't know what you're talking about.
Are your boots warm, crew? Welcome, it's such a pleasure to see you again. Have you seen anything?
I'm conducting an investigation. Apparently, some merchants are being extorted by some members of the guard.
Really? That's terrible, Your Excellency.
As legate, it is my duty to ensure the safety and well-being of the citizens of our town. So please, if you have any information...
I don't know anything. Really? I have only been here for a few months. My partner, who ran the shop before me, had a very bad encounter.
And you fear the same thing happening to you?
This is what happens around here. So I prefer to hold my tongue and do what is expected of me.
If you denounce them, we could end this and charge these men for their crime.
I can't take that risk. There are so many of them. Also, I would not be able to name them. Now, I would like to get back to my work. What we need is the money to return, do you understand? We are very monitored.
I have a plan to stop the culprits, but I'm going to need your help. The next time one of these guards comes to squeeze money out of you, you must ask for more time. The man will threaten you, of course, and he will certainly bring his accomplices. But when they come back in full force to make you pay for your audacity, we will be there to apprehend them.
And if your plan fails, I'll end up like Renault. You don't understand.
These guards really managed to terrify you. I'll be back later, hoping you've changed your mind.
Thank you for your... visit. See you soon. Welcome! It's such a pleasure.
Have you seen it?
Have you reconsidered?
I'm sorry, but I have not changed my...
Are you not tired of giving them your share of the profits? And do you not want to avenge your partner?
He was my friend, and his debt.
These guards ri-
Thank you. You'll find all you need in our... Welcome!
Have you...
Have you recon... Are you... And do you-
He was my friend.
Thank you for your...
Welcome!
Have you reconsidered?
I'm sorry, but...
Are you... And do you...
Thank you for your visit.
Have you recon... Are you... And do you...
Thank you for your... Your boot! Welcome!
Have you seen...
Have you recon... Are you not... And do you...
He was my friend. Thank you for your visit. See you soon. You'll find all you need.
Well, have you?
Have you reconsidered? Are you- And do you-
Thank you for your visit. Your boots won't through. Well-
Have you reconsidered? Are you not- And do you-
Poor Renault. He didn't deserve it. Perhaps you're right, and we need to act. I will do what you ask of me. But for God's sake, when they threaten me, intervene right away.
Fear not. We will not let them harm you. When should they be returning?
It's hard to predict. Given their habits, I would say in 2 days, maybe?
Perfect. I will not fail you.
Thank you for your visit. See you soon.
Atoy, Sien Sradidao Quint, Dadagudachme in.
Attention, soldier.
Let me pass. I must see the chief of your village. Whatever could be so funny.
Now, who would you be to seek an audience with the governor?
I am Siora, daughter of Bladnir. My mother is Amal, the chief of our clan. I am here as an emissary of my people, and I must see your chief, your governor.
So you are a princess, then?
A what?
Let her pass. Your Majesty, I shall present you to the governor. Come.
Princess, Majesty, you are most confusing, but thank you for your help.
Come closer, good people. The cure and wine from the continent.
Are your boots worn through? Is your hat out of style? Welcome. It's such a pleasure.
Have you seen any? So, did they take the bait?
Yes, Your Excellency. And I am very happy to see you. One of them came to the shop yesterday. He gave me 24 hours to raise the money required, which means that the entire gang could appear any minute now.
Perfect. I'll hide and wait for their arrival. And rest assured, I will not let them go.
Thank you for your visit. See you soon.
I hope you have what we're looking for, my good friend. Our man with the silver coin is not known for his patience.
Well, I moved heaven and earth to collect the sum, but alas, I ran out of time.
More fool you if you think Egon will be satisfied with your sorry excuses. You know what happens to those who refuse to pay.
Leave this man alone at once. You're under arrest.
We'll see about that. And who will stop us? We are the guard.
You certainly don't deserve such a name. Bunch of cowards.
Yield without a fuss and you'll have the right to a trial.
Really? And then it'll be the gallows. Do you think we're pushovers?
I'm eternally grateful, Your Excellency. You saved my trade and my life.
Stay alert. Their leader was obviously not present.
I heard about the man with the silver coin, but this is the first time they told me his name.
If they let him escape, it's only because they were thinking of killing you.
I beg you, find this Egon and stop him. None of us will be safe as long as he's free.
Don't worry. I don't intend to let him go. We must find this Egon. At the barracks, perhaps.
I doubt our man goes openly by that name. It is the silver coin we must look for.
So, men, how's it going?
Everything's fine, Lieutenant.
Nothing to report. All our friends are quiet.
Perfectly quiet. As soon as they hear about a silver coin, they start trembling.
Good. It would be a shame to have to make another example of them, right?
Oh, there's no need, Lieutenant. They've been as sweet as lambs since Renault's accident.
Accidents happen so quickly. I'm waiting for another delivery today. Have you seen your comrades?
No, they must have stopped at the tavern on the way. As soon as we see them, we'll send them your way, Lieutenant.
I hope those idiots aren't drinking my dew.
No one would dare do that to you, Lieutenant.
I hope not. Well, I'll have to remind them that the silver coin can shake everyone. Even the guards. Well, I'll lead you. I have urgent business to attend to. Now, don't forget to send me those drunkards.
Farewell, Lieutenant.
There's no doubt. Here is our man. Let's follow him discreetly.
Who are you? You're following me.
Indeed. We would like to talk to you about the silver coin, Egon.
Egon? You must be mistaken. I don't know anyone by that name.
Do not take us for fools. We heard you speak with your men.
I don't know what you've heard, but you're wrong. I'm not Egon.
Regardless, you are implicated in a murder and in the extortion of merchants. You are therefore under arrest. And we will finish by having you tell us who Egon is and where to find him.
Oh, yes. We'll see about that.
Come on.
So, have you finally decided to follow us?
So you can torture me. You can do whatever you want. I'll not tell you anything. I don't know who Egon is. I'm just a middleman. You're wasting your time.
You must know more than you're willing to say. Come on!
I'd rather die.
His symbol of recognition. I have to show it to Manfred.
Hello, Your Excellency. What can I do for you?
I conducted my investigation on the extortion organized by members of the Guard. I think I've put an end to it, at least temporarily. Unfortunately, I had to kill some of them as they were about to attack a merchant. But there are still some other soldiers involved that I should tell you about.
Thank you, Your Excellency. I will have these men arrested immediately. These foolish brutes not only harm your merchants, but the entire reputation of the Guard. But you said you've only put an end to it temporarily. What makes you think this criminality might resume?
Their leader is still on the loose. They call him Egon, although I doubt it's his real name. I got hold of one of his lieutenants. He was carrying a silver coin, which seems to be a symbol of recognition between the gang members. But the man preferred to die rather than tell us anything about his leader.
Loyalty or terror?
Terror, I fear. From the merchants to the guards, everyone seems to tremble in front of this Egon.
I don't know any guard of that name, but as you said, it's probably a pseudonym. Here, Your Excellency, take this. On behalf of the Guard, to thank you for settling this case. And rest assured that I will conduct a thorough investigation on my side. I'll also make sure that in future the City Guard is made up only of men of trust.
Thank you. I will return to see how your investigation is going. I don't take this matter lightly.
Is there anything else?
No, thank you.
Things are about to get messy.
There you are, dear cousin.
What is this?
Who is this amazing person in your company?
I am Siora, daughter of Bladnid, daughter of Meb. My mother is the Maal, the chief of our clan.
I am honored to make your acquaintance, Siora. This is incredible. You look so much alike, you could be related. If you would allow me, Princess, I would like to confer a mission to my cousin. You need to visit the governors of the bridge and Teleme to give them my formal regards, that sort of thing, but also to discover what they've managed to learn. They've been here much longer than we have. Perhaps they've made some inroads to finding a cure for the Malachor.
Forgive me, Maal, but I have a request for you. My people needs your help.
I thought we might discuss matters together at leisure, but please, speak your piece.
The Lions, the Bridge Alliance and my people are at war. My mother has sent me to you in search of allies. I fear that without your help, our clan will suffer great horrors. We have already lost so many souls.
This seems a sensible request. You know, though, we cannot go to war with our neighbors.
Perhaps there is a way to negotiate a ceasefire, the time to see things more clearly.
Excellent idea. I would be completely lost without you. Go and parley with, the Queen, dear cousin. Try and put an end to confrontations for the time being.
I will come with you. It will take more than one person to convince my mother to lay down our weapons.
Perfect. Take Kurt along with you and anyone you feel useful. I've been told that the roads are not safe. Safe travels, dear cousin. And watch out for yourself. I wouldn't want anything bad to happen to you.